My name is Vikrant. I'm the co-founder and CTO of Dataweave, a company which provides competitive intelligence solutions to retailers and consumer brands. Right. My today's talk is focused on how businesses across different verticals can leverage publicly available data on the web, right, for making smarter decisions. So if you see, if I have to put a question this way, right, how well does businesses really use external data? So predominantly, if you see, most of the organizations traditionally have been used to the way of using internal data for most of the decision making. Maybe primarily because it's easily accessible and usable, right? But given the advent of digitalization and more companies moving towards the web, where they use web as a platform for performing most of their operations, and since we are moving towards a connected world, more and more businesses are moving online, right? So this actually gives us a great opportunity where these organizations or these activities are leaving a trail of data on the web. And when these data points are picked up in the right format and harnessed in the right way, they can give us great insights, which help us to take better, smarter, deliberate decisions, right? So the another concept that I would also want to propose is most of the companies have internal data for most of their which they have been tracking over a period of time, which they would have collected over a period of time, right? But a lot of times what happens is there are a bunch of external factors which keep impacting businesses, right? When you augment your internal data with these external data, you will be able to derive better insights. That's that's a concept that we're talking about, right? This concept actually applies to multiple verticals. Here I'm covering a couple of verticals where I would like to give some examples on how external web data can be used, right? Let's look at retailers. Currently, retailers can use external data to compare themselves with both online retailers as well as offline retailers to understand how price competitive they are, to compare their assortments with their competitions, and also to take better pricing decisions overall, right? Similarly, consumer brands, since consumer brands use online as one of the biggest channels to sell their products, and they can actually leverage the available public data on the web to track what kind of promotions their competitors are doing, or what is their share of voice in the online space with respect to the kind of promotions that are being run on the online space. Right. All these external factors can be leveraged to take better decisions. Similarly, in the travel space, the OTAs have impacted traditional travel businesses the same way e-commerce has turned into retail. Right. So here as well, by tracking how prices are changing dynamically and what are all the various factors that can impact the price change, OTAs can travel. People in the travel industry can take better decisions. Another vertical is around private equity firms and investment firms, right? These guys are also constantly looking for external data to take better decisions, right? So one instance can be, what if I can use external data points to understand and take decisions with respect to a buying or a selling of a stock, right? And there is also this entire emerging field which is called alternative data, which are basically data sets which are very unique and not traditionally available through normal means. These gives them an edge with respect to taking better decisions, right? This is not a new thing, right? Web has been there for a very long time and data has been available for quite some time, right? But if you see, businesses don't use it, and it's not so ubiquitous that everyone uses external data for their day-to-day processing or day-to-day decision making, right? So these are some of the challenges that currently businesses face with respect to using external data. One is that web is massive. Data on the web is completely unstructured, and also there is a lot of noise. There is very high noise to signal ratio, and also data is scattered across multiple sources, right? If you take any one particular source, data will almost always be incomplete. You might have to aggregate data from multiple sources, and also data is dynamically changing. Right. What happens? If you see the current scenario, most companies either have makeshift products or they do a one-time activity of manually scraping or They actually subscribe to some scraping services where they collect this data on a one-time basis. But the real potential of external data lies in collecting and aggregating this data in a consistent manner over a period of time and continuously analyzing and picking up signals. Right? So to address this challenge, we are proposing this proposing an architecture which is very ideal for this scenario. So what we're trying to say here is there are a lot of publicly available sources on, there are a lot of multiple sources on the web. If you can build a distributed data aggregation engine which can seamlessly pull data and then remove noise, do some sort of pre-processing where you define a schema or you start picking up relevant data points, and then use AIML to actually scale these operations, right? And one other important factor here is not every algorithm is perfect or not every model that you build can solve all your problems, right? That's where we also propose this novel approach where you involve humans, right? So we call it the human in the loop angle, where whenever your machine learning algorithm scores are low or your model scores are low or whenever you need to build a training set, right, you can use humans to build a small training set and then use your run it on the large data set to build better models and scale your operations. Through this process, you can actually get the data in the right format. Once you have the data in the right format, you can actually use it for you can run it through standard engines to derive insights and also get better take better decisions, right? So I would like to present a case study which is actually built on the same architecture that just previously proposed. There was a survey which was done on around 6,000 odd online shoppers, consumers, and what it has been found is that 38% of the customers have actually received a counterfeit product, which is actually a duplicate product. This primarily happens predominantly in the online space because it's easier to replicate an online catalog actually replace the original product with a duplicate product, right? This is a huge problem that currently brands faces there is a huge dilution that happens to the brand, which maybe a brand would have carefully built over a period of time, right? So this case study is about, can brands really use external data to fight this challenge, right? So for this problem statement, what we've done is we worked with a major outdoor gear manufacturer, right? So where we have taken 500 products as input, right? So these products are actually the original products, and we have considered 8 different online sources, retail websites, where we have aggregated information from these websites, and then we tried to classify counterfeits into these 3 categories. One is fake products, where basically the catalog information is either inconsistent, the product name can be the same, but the catalog information is inconsistent, or is being sold by an unauthorized seller, or is being maybe sold dirt cheap, right? Like, a lot of times you see these things where you see a very good Puma shoe being sold for $500 or something, right? Which means it can be a duplicate product, right? That's one thing. And the other one is around unauthorized white labeling, where the catalog from an online retailer is copied. Like, for example, you as an actual brand publish your catalog on the web, and then someone copies your entire catalog information, including the proprietary information like images and everything that has been published, and then they use it for a counterfeit product for selling, right? Which will actually be used for misleading consumers. And then the third case is around image theft, where you use and copy an actual image of the actual product and use it for selling a different product. This is also a common practice in the online space, right? What we've done here is we've used a similar architecture that we have proposed earlier. So we've aggregated data, and also in this process we have done 2 things. One is we have processed both textual information from the product and also the image information, right? Once we've processed it, we've done feature extraction based on the extracted features. You use AIML to map similar products together, right? Like identify, okay, what are these counterfeit products, like the 3 categories that have found, right? And then once you have built this data set where you have categorized and identified these mappings, to improve the accuracy, we also use the human in the loop approach, where humans will tag if there are any inaccuracies in the system, and then that goes as a feedback to the system again, algorithmically, right? From, I'd like to show some examples. For example, this is a paid product, right? But actually the image and some of the catalog information is used from an original product. How do you detect it? The price is almost one third of the original price. Then it is being sold by another reseller, right? These kind of things are very hard to find on a website just by searching, because some websites have millions of product listings. Unless you process these images in a systematic way, you will not be able to get these things. Right? Another counterfeit example is around unauthorized white labeling. So here, actually the original image of the original product has been used for selling a duplicate product, where the image logo has been removed by Photoshop or any photo processing tool. These kind of images also can be detected using the system, right? And then it can be flagged off as a counterfeit. And the third one is around using the original image, right? So the actual image is of a product which is supposed to be an axle wheel cover, but the image is copied and used for a different product altogether, right? So this is also some tactic that is used for misleading. Right? So through this exercise, what we were able to discover is that 50% of the products that we have analyzed had counterfeits across websites. And there are some stats that have been published here, right? So we were able to only do this because of the way in which we have processed this, right? Because when you look at web data, it's really huge. Some of these online retailers have millions of listings, and it's very hard to find these things. And that's one of the reasons some of these unauthorized sellers take advantage of this and keep selling these products on the online space, where it causes both consumer dissonance and as well as it also reduces the brand image, right? So what actions can be taken here? So we can directly contact these sellers, and then brands can directly contact these sellers and ask them to remove these product listings. Or they can actually contact the marketplace and also ask them to maybe ban the seller. And you can also send DMCA notices to bring down the product listings. There are a lot of interesting challenges that you can solve by using web data, right? So this is one example which is very particular to retail, but there are a lot of interesting challenges that you can solve using web data. So we can catch up if you have any questions or like if you have any questions. Yeah, sure.
Do you have kind of similar solution for the video space also? Like there are many cases we have seen that the videos are not licensed and they are, you know, probably copied from somewhere else and just put on the other website. So do you also have similar solution to figure out those threats?
Currently we don't have a solution for video in per se, but you can use a similar architecture to detect these things. We predominantly work in the space of publicly available data, where we process and provide solutions around data which is publicly available, and we work with retailers currently. But as a solution, in theory, it is possible, yes. There are some solutions available. It definitely can be done.